paras korkeakoulu opiskelijalle.
Hello everyone and welcome to this new episode of Visit SeAMK Week. My name is Andres Mendez and I have the pleasure to introduce you to a new degree program. In this occasion, we'll talk about Agri-food Engineering. And we have with us today none other than Ilmari Ayo. Hello, Ilmari.
Hello, Andres, and thank you for having me.
Yes, how are you?
I'm fine. It's a great Tuesday.
And you are here, you are a lecturer in Agri-food Engineering.
Yes, so I teach mainly food technology subjects.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about Agri-food Engineering. Like, what do students do and what is the program all about?
Agri-food Engineering is, of course, about food. It's there's two main parts. There's agri-food part and then there's a food technology part. Agri-food part is more about where the raw materials come from. What is the idea behind of those? What is the key points in there? And in food technology part, we are aiming to understand how we are able to turn those raw materials into a product that we are able to sell for consumers.
Okay, so the students are able to learn the process from the raw material to the developing of the food?
From field to fork, yes.
Interesting, yes. Field to fork. Yeah, that's a nice concept. Yeah, I like it.
Yes.
Okay, so for example, how long is this degree program last for?
This is 240 credits, and it usually takes 4 years.
4 years, okay.
The student comes first, meaning that of course it's planned for 4 years. But of course we are flexible about if you're able to do it faster, of course we usually find ways of doing that. And if students are taking their time doing student exchange and going abroad and learning more in other universities, that might take a longer time.
Okay, so while the students are taking the courses here and everything, they can also do an exchange and learn like from other universities and other processes and other raw materials. Yeah. That's interesting.
It's really, really good that we are able to widen our views. And since SeAMK has cooperation around the globe, you are able to choose from quite many universities and study well this food engineering or agricultural things in other universities.
And I have a question that is a little bit more in a personal interest.
Yes?
Do students, for example, do they have the opportunity to choose between food, drinks, or you know, to prepare certain type of foods?
We will give all the students a certain background from all of this, but going these free studies, you're able to focus more on certain topics like the drinks or meat or bakery, but everybody will get the basic understanding.
And what are some of the courses that students will go through in their education here at SeAMK? Could you tell us a little bit?
In agri-food part, there is courses about these forest raw materials like berries and parts that come from field. Also about how we get the meat, how we grow animals, that kind of stuff. In food engineering part, we are focusing on how to turn those materials, raw materials, to products, and in there we are starting with these basic processes, understanding what are the key ones and how we are able, what kind of effect they have to a product. And of course, since students will graduate as engineers, we have that basic courses on mathematics, physics, chemistry, and that kind of stuff. And also, since we are becoming engineers, there's some kind of this management kind of courses like industrial management.
Okay, That is very interesting that they can learn from the agricultural part and become engineers at the same time. Yeah. That's a very interesting program.
Yeah, and how I see it is that the more wider understanding we have about this one word food, the more skilled we are to make the right decisions. Okay.
And for example, when students graduate, what is the most common places where they can work, or you know, what can their career after studies can look like?
Usually, when students graduate and get some kind of work, they will become some kind of assistants, specialists. Engineering, like a development engineer. In this SeAMK area, we have a huge variety of different food companies. Mm-hmm. And even in Finnish scale, they are big ones, meaning that they have a huge variety of positions where our students can work after graduating. And we have even cases that persons who has graduated from us has continued their good job in work life and becoming even CEOs in good size companies.
That's interesting. Yeah. You know, being myself from Mexico, I can always just think about, food, you know.
Yeah. Well, it's a huge drinks. Part of a huge part of our daily life. Everybody needs to eat every day. And yeah, how to make it more easier for everyone, how to make it how to be able to make better food for everyone, that you are not going to grow big too big.
Ilmari, another question, for example, what is it that makes this program so special that we had to have a program in English? You know, because this program has been existing at SeAMK in Finnish, of course, for many years. But, you know, like, what it makes it so attractive that that international students would like to join this program?
How I see it is that we take the wide scope on this subject of food. We usually focus on one thing and go deeper. With this program, we take the wider set and we get the good understanding of the whole variety. And that makes it so special. In our teaching methods, of course, how we see things is that in classrooms, you're able to learn up till one point of just reading the books and listening to teachers. In here, we want to take our students to our laboratories and where they can take that knowledge from classroom and see it or feel it or demonstrate it by themselves and learn by doing.
Yeah, because I can see right now that we are located in one of the labs.
Yes.
Could you
yes.
tell us a little bit what happens in here today?
This is our agricultural lab, and in the background you are able to see our soil samples, what has been taken from the field, and they will check the ingredients from there, and with that they are able to make a plan what kind of supplements they need to put to the field that those crops would grow better. And that kind of stuff we are able to see.
So there is a lot of dirt in all these little containers.
Yes, and that's interesting.
It is, yes. It is.
Yes, but also we have a good variety of a different kind of machinery in our university that we are able to use and demonstrate for our students. And of course, it's key point is that they will use it and learn by doing.
Yeah, so we have this program in English, and I know that Finnish students like to learn in English as well because they want to probably use their skill and their knowledge in another country, living in another place. But then we want to bring students to, you know, to SeAMK, to SeAMK, to study mm-hmm. with us. And I'm just wondering what kind of international experience can the students have while studying with us?
Yes. Of course, the most common thing is the student exchange that we provide the chance for all our students coming from abroad or from Finland that they are able to take their time to abroad and study more. But of course, we have five different programs in here, international programs, and one of the of them is masters. And here's a lot of international students, and we are happy to have them. And almost doesn't matter where you go, you will always hear other languages than just Finnish, which is good.
Yeah, I guess it's very interesting. Myself as a foreigner, I can identify 100% with what you're saying, because when you look at SeAMK being in like such a small area and in a smaller country, still Finland is able to have a wide reach, you know, of international audience, you know, and students, a lot of interest to come and study here. And it's true, you know, it's very interesting walking through campus and then to see a group of students speaking one language and then other students speaking another language. And it's always this interest, you know, of getting to know who they are and where they're coming from, but also what they're studying, you know, because they all come from different countries and studying different fields. And that is very nice.
Yes, totally agree. And I was teaching this basic processes course for AFE, and we had great discussions about different methods how students are making food in their back home. Those were the methods that we are not using that much in here. We might have heard, but it was for me it was a great learning experience. Like, oh, you do that. Please explain more. So, learning from each other,
it's a great experience. And for example, how is SeAMK? How is like living here for foreigners? How do you think it is, especially with the weather, for example? It gets really cold in here. And what about, you know, when the students come from warm places, and what about the distances? What can you tell us about SeAMK?
About the weather. I see it as a plus side that we have four seasons. We don't have the just the warm and cold seasons. We also have spring and autumn, which are really beautiful seasons. So I see it as a plus, but it's in one point it will get dark and cold, but. again, we know that it doesn't last long. The season will change, but in overall, SeAMK, this is nice package of everything what you need in a certain area. The campus is located right next to our city center. It's just a walk. Our campus area is beautiful. The river is crossing our campus. We study in both sizes and
I know that it can be scary for some students, you know, when we talk about minus 20 degrees or so, but also it has its beauty. And also we have a lot of winter activities, students, you know, we try to promote as well that not just because it's cold, you have to be at home with a blanket, you know, you can also go out and do other winter activities. And that is very interesting here in Finland.
I agree. And how I see the winter when it's minus 20 degrees and lots of snow, it's not the coldest time of the year for me, even though it might sound so, but it's that beautiful. And when there's the snow, it's just bright. So that is so nice.
Yeah. And what about summer?
Summer is too short.
Summer is short.
It's short, but it's so beautiful when the nature, nature, whole city, even the school comes to life.
Yes. Well, all this has been very useful information. But one last question. Why would you think, or why would foreigner students should consider studying at SeAMK?
we have been chosen to be the best University of Applied Sciences in Finland a few times in a row. We put we care about our students. If they will succeed, I as a teacher, I have to succeed. So it's my point that I will help them to grow and shine. So how I see students should consider SeAMK, since we really care about our students.
Ilmari, I want to thank you for having us here today. Thank you for the time. Thank you for your answers. I'm sure that all our viewers will be happy and more curious, you know, to know more about this program. And I'm sure they can come and visit to our website and read all the information about Agri-food Engineering program. Any last words that you would like to say to our viewers today?
I'm happy that people are watching this video. Hope that this answers some of your questions, and I really hope that I will see a lot of new students in coming years.
It will be great. Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.